You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Monday, May 11th, 2020. This week on Catholic Sprouts, we are going to be celebrating our Blessed Mother Mary by continuing to look at her amazing apparitions, times when she has appeared to people with a specific message. Last week, we talked about Our Lady of Guadalupe and Juan Diego. This week, we're going to be talking about Our Lady of Fatima because we are celebrating the feast day of Our Lady of Fatima on Wednesday. Now, Our Lady of Fatima references a time when Mary appeared to three poor shepherd children in Fatima, Portugal. And this happened a lot more recently than when Mary appeared to Juan Diego in Mexico. In fact, it happened just over 100 years ago. And there's a lot of things that are different between when Mary appeared in Mexico and when she appeared in Fatima, but it is still the same mother. Now, before we dive into what happened in Fatima, let's talk about yesterday for a moment. Now, I hope, Sprouts, that yesterday you took time to celebrate your mom. At least here in the United States, yesterday was Mother's Day. It is a great time to make your mother feel extra special. Now, even if you happen to be a person whose mother is not with them now, has died, or is just not present for the moment, I want you to remember that we all, no matter who we are, have a mother that loves us perfectly. And that mother is, of course, Mary. Remember, when Jesus was dying on the cross, he made sure to tell his disciple that Mary was now his mother. And he told Mary that she was to take care of this person as her child. Now, Jesus wasn't just talking to that one disciple. He was talking to all of us. Mary really is our mother. And this is the reason why she appears to people, why she appears to people with a message like she did with Juan Diego and in Fatima. But she also works on the hearts of us in a private way. Maybe she has a very private message for us, and maybe we only understand that message gradually after years and years of praying the rosary. It's not some big appearance. It might be, but it might not be. Mary really does love us in such a motherly way. Just like when you get hurt, your mom doesn't like to see that. They sometimes even cry with you. Mary is the same way. She doesn't like to see you hurt, and she wants what is best for you. Now, the message of Fatima is all about conversion, prayer, and penance. This is the message that Mary had for the whole world. And she spoke to three poor children and told them to bring this message to the world, that we needed to be converted, that we needed to commit ourselves to prayer, and that we needed to embrace suffering and penance. Now, we're going to talk about all of these things, but keep these things in mind this week. You need to change your ways and live better. You need to be converted. You need to pray every single day, every single day. And you need to suffer and offer that suffering to Mary and Jesus. Okay, so let's talk about Fatima. So as I mentioned, Mary appeared in Fatima, Portugal to three poor shepherd children. These children were Lucia and her two cousins, Jacinta and Francisco. Now, Lucia was the oldest. She was just 10 years old. Francisco was 8, and his little sister, Jacinta, was 7. Now, their family were poor, and they were farmers. And so every day, the family would send these three children out to watch the sheep. And they spent long, maybe even boring days out in the pasture. They would eat their lunch, and then they would play games while they watched the sheep and eventually brought them back home in the evening. They passed the time by playing games. They were Catholic and they loved their faith, so they knew that they needed to spend some of that time out in the pasture praying. They tried to pray the rosary, but they oftentimes either skipped it or said it really fast. Now, Mary picked these three children to be her messengers to the world. So if you're thinking, well, they're my age, if you're 10 years old or younger, that's right. Mary could have picked you. She picked someone your age. So to prepare these three children to really receive the message from heaven, the year before the apparitions, Mary started sending an angel to these children. The angel appeared, and of course the children were scared, but he told them, don't be afraid. He identified himself as the angel of peace and the protector of Portugal. And this angel got to work teaching the children how to pray. He taught them two specific prayers. The first one is very simple, and it goes like this. My God, I believe, I adore, I hope, and I love you. I ask pardon for all those who do not believe, who do not hope, who do not adore, and who do not love you. Now, he taught the children not only these words, but also how to pray. And he really inspired in these children the dedication to pray. He also showed them the Eucharist and taught them a prayer that honors Jesus, present in the Eucharist in all the tabernacles of the world. So with the angel's help, these three children learned how to pray. They learned how serious it is to need to pray every day and the right way to pray with your whole heart and your whole mind focused on what you're doing. So after the angel appeared to the three children, they didn't just rush through their rosary. They didn't dismiss this so that they could play games. They got very serious about praying. They were ready to meet Mary. And Mary did appear to them. We're going to learn how she appeared to them 6 times over 6 months and the amazing things that she taught them, that she asked them to do, and how they were transformed after spending time with Mary. But we will get to that later this week. Today, my friends, I have a challenge for you. Now, Our Lady of Fatima is also called Our Lady of the Rosary. She identified herself that way when she was talking to the children, and she was constantly reminding them to pray the rosary every day. Now, how old are you? Are you 7, 8, 9, 10? Remember, Jacinta was only 7 years old when Mary started appearing to her. And she didn't say, okay, Jacinta, when you're a little bit older, you can start praying the rosary. No, she said, now. Now, you need to be praying the rosary every day. And so, Sprouts, my challenge to you, find your rosary. And all on your own, with no one's help, I want you to pray at least 1 decade of that rosary today. If you can pray more, that's wonderful. But you are not too young to be praying the rosary all by yourself. Believe that. Mary told these three children that, so it has to be true. Find your rosary and start praying. That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be. Hey there, Sprouts. Just a little reminder as we go through this week on Our Lady of Fatima that we offer patches at Catholic Sprouts. And if all of this has motivated you to start praying the rosary or going to adoration or even praying scripture, we encourage you to really commit and start earning a patch. We offer all sorts of free patches for beautiful acts of faith as Catholics. You can start earning these. They are 100% free. Just head to catholicsprouts.com/challenge patches to learn all about it, or you can find a direct link in the notes for this podcast episode. Once again, they're totally free. Just start earning and mail it in for your patch.